This week, Channel 4 aired the first episode of Naked Education. It's a show that's been promoted as being all about body positivity. But many viewers were shocked to see a group of adults stripping off in front of children aged 14 to 16. Now, before we discuss this, let's take a quick look at what all the fuss is about with the naughty bits. Don't worry, they have been covered.
Physical?
I couldn't look at them. I don't think my cat's even got that much hair.
You're giggling quite a lot back there.
I'm always the one that giggles.
Bobby, how do you feel?
I feel fine.
Casual question.
Not even bothered.
I mean, I've never been in a room with four naked people. They've never been in a room with four naked people. Maybe Dr. Alex has. I'm not sure. Elliot, you've got naked people standing in front of you.
Yes, I do.
Is this a new thing, a new experience? I'm guessing it probably is.
Yeah, it is a bit.
I don't think I've been in a room with four naked people either, but that's probably a different story. So has Channel 4 gone too far this time? I'm joined by Steve Beegoo, Head of Education at Christian Concern. Thank you for joining me. So, has it gone too far, or is this just educational television all about body positivity?
Yes, it has gone too far, in my opinion. I think this is appalling. It's framing these things as a form of education. The very title is Naked Education. And they claim to be being body positive. They often talk about being sex positive and say this is all fine. But the process of trying to help these young people feel positive about their bodies is to, as you've seen there on that clip, to have naked adults parading before them, the 14-year-olds, some of these children, parading their sexual parts in front of these children. And, of course, this is one of those stages of just kind of breaking down those natural embarrassment. I mean, you could see those teenagers giggling there, couldn't you? They weren't quite sure what to do with what it was that they were seeing. There's this natural, inbuilt sense of, well, these parts are private, aren't they? We shouldn't really be looking at each other's private parts in this kind of way. And framing it as education is a really kind of clever way to try and expose and increase this kind of nakedness more clearly on the media.
Is there a difference between what our emotional response should be if these were happening in every school versus it's a TV show? The Channel 4 said that the correct consent, one would imagine both the child and the parents, was given before they took part in it.
Well, that's a fascinating question. I mean, I was a head teacher for many years, and this whole question of consent is fascinating. If a child was to come to me, a year nine child or third year, perhaps when you or I or some of your viewers were at school, and to say, do you know what I've had some adults, four adults, demonstrate their genitals to me. And I was in this kind of classroom setting, and they showed me their things, and I gave consent for this to happen as a child, and my parents also gave consent for me to be shown these naked people. As a head teacher or a designated safeguarding lead, I would be taking notes on that, and I would be raising it as a safeguarding concern, regardless of whether it's a television program or if it's going on in every class. These are children here who are being exposed to this. And are they really Gillick competent to say, oh, yes, I'm psychologically ready to be seeing this and to be having these discussions with these adults, which is all very, it's normalising and it's kind of desensitising them to the idea of having strangers naked before them.
It's been a long while since I learned the basics about all of this. I remember most of it, but I can't remember what age we were shown things. So pictures of genitals would have been taught to us in sex education, and that certainly happened at the secondary school. So we might have been talking about those ages. It must have been before we finished GCSE. So in that age group, I guess I was showed pictures of these kind of things. Mm-hmm. Is there a difference between a picture and having... I mean, I suppose there is. It's the three dimensions. But how much of a difference does it make when you're seeing a live model?
It's more than just the three dimensions. You can see that there's kind of an engagement between these children and these adults, an engagement, the eye contact, the communication. And, of course, as this program continues, these children are being encouraged to really sympathize with these adults. Some of them have got some key issues. I mean, one of them has got some issues to do with hair growth, polycystic ovaries. And that's a serious issue that does need to be raised and talked about sensibly, but raised and talked about sensibly. And the way in which they were doing it was to cause these children to feel empathy towards them. These 14-year-olds feel empathy towards them. Of course they should be allowed to be themselves. Of course they should be free. But the way in which you educate children about these things is not by showing them naked adults and trying to get them to in this kind of desensitizing way, feel sympathy for them, but actually talk about them, these things with parents, with trusted teachers, without having to have a naked body in front of you. I mean, part of the issue with all of this is it's kind of hiding in plain sight. I mean, you've already referenced Jimmy Savile earlier on. My feelings around this kind of things is these kind of things being done in this public way kind of allows them to hide almost. This is just education. The way in which it's framed is very, very dubious and quite disturbing.
OK, so let me bring in Peter again. Are we being a prude here, or is it simply that these issues of polycystic ovaries, the thing that one should learn about, but we could learn about all of these things to do with body confidence, with something covering the you-know-what?
Yeah, I have to admit, this is a really interesting kind of situation. I'd love to know how this show actually got commissioned in the first place. I'd love to know the safeguarding and how they've actually put it all together. But we do have an increase in things like eating disorders. There's, you know, the problems of social media, and there are real problems that this show is trying to tackle. I just don't think this is the right way to actually go about trying to tackle those issues. I think in the typical Channel 4 way, they've kind of jumped in with 2 feet and not really thought about it very much.
Yeah. Steve, would you agree with that then, that actually the intention is good and it's just the execution that's the problem you disagree with?
Well, there are definitely issues here. I mean, large numbers of children are watching pornography, these augmented bodies, heavily shaven bodies, and they're seeing all of these things and they're obviously looking at their own bodies and thinking, my body's different from that. The way to solve this is not by having more adult nakedness in front of children. I mean, in what world is that going to help solve these kinds of issues? There are all sorts of issues with our children and sexting, sexual images being sent between children, being sent from adults to children. I mean, one in every primary school class, one in 25 from an NSPCC survey, have been sent a sexual image from an adult or another young person in the primary school. This isn't talking about the teenagers. So we have a huge issue around this pornification of society. But this is not the way to solve those issues. We need to find other ways to protect children and to teach children effectively that do not involve adults who, some of these adults, they kind of sex toy, they do sex toys reviews, they do songs about masturbation. These are the kind of adults that are being put there to help teach these young children through demonstrating the nakedness of their bodies. This is not the way to deal with these issues.
But we've just, and I'm guilty of this as well. I've been guilty of this all day reading this story, of falling back into the trap of thinking this is a lesson taking place in a school because that's what it looks like. But it's not taking place in schools, is it? This is a thing taking place in a TV studio. And it's difficult for us to separate that out in our minds, which might be a flaw of the TV show.
Well, one of the things about all this, of course, is that in our classrooms across the country, here at Christian Concern, we're hearing time and time again that very inappropriate things are being taught to children with very graphic and visual imagery. And so this isn't so far away from what is already happening in many schools, where gender identity politics is being enforced on children without parents' consent, without parents understanding what's going on. We have parents all the time and teachers as well coming to us at Christian Concern saying, I can't understand why this is being allowed. And in many ways, what we're seeing here is that potentially the next step towards the kind of education that the sexual progressives would really love to see being put
just
in front
finally,
of children.
Who should teach this stuff then? Who do you think should teach this stuff?
Number one, parents. Parents love their children. Parents know their children. If you're a parent here, please talk to your children about these key issues before somebody else does. Because they, if they're interested in these kinds of issues and they're curious, and they will be, and you're not teaching about them, somebody else will be. And can you really trust those people that they are searching on the internet to find these answers from? No.
Steve, thank you for that. Steve Beegoo, Head of Education at Christian Concern.